Our team has received a ton of requests for this, so here's a video on everything you need to know about FluentCRM's global settings. So let's get to it. First, let's pull up the Settings tab from FluentCRM's dashboard. At the top of the list is Business Settings. This is where you can set your business name, business full address, and logo. Simply fill out the fields and select an image with the Upload button. We'll go ahead and save the settings, and business setup is complete. The next item on the list is Global Email Settings. This is where you set up the default display information, such as sent from name and email ID. Enter the name of the email sender in the From Name field and add the email address that will be used to send the emails in the From Email Address field. Note that these need to be supported by your email service provider and SMTP settings. For smooth routing and email deliverability, we're using Fluent SMTP. It's a completely free SMTP plugin dedicated to work with FluentCRM. Fluent SMTP supports popular marketing email services like Amazon SES, Mailgun, SendGrid, SendinBlue, SparkPost, PeppyPost, and you can use multiple email accounts to route your WordPress emails and marketing emails simultaneously. All you have to do is to configure Fluent SMTP with the email address you made with your email service provider and paste it into FluentCRM's email settings. If your emails aren't sent as no-reply threads, you can set a reply to name an email address as well. In this case, we'll set a reply to name in the field. Now, if you have a separate inbox for reply emails, you can set the reply to email address in the reply to email field. If your audience wants to get back to you, their email will be forwarded to the reply to address. The email settings is also where you can modify your email footer. You can add media and even visually format text. Make sure to include your business name, address, and the unsubscribe link to avoid being flagged as spam. At the bottom of the page, you'll find the email preference settings. Here, you can grant your subscribers the privilege to manage their email preferences. If you don't want contacts to manage their email subscriptions, you need to select No, Contact cannot manage list subscriptions. Otherwise, you can select and specify the lists your users can choose from. If you want all of your lists to be manageable by users, you can do that too. That's pretty much all there is to email settings. Next, we'll go to General Settings. On this tab, you can set up how FluentCRM will manage new WordPress user signup and common subscription. Under User Signup Opt-in Settings, you can choose whether you want to add a new contact for new WordPress user signup. You can also select lists and tags they'll be assigned. After this, now we can set Comment Form Subscription Settings. This lets you prompt for a new contact creation when a user submits a comment on your comment submission form. We have these settings enabled by ticking Enable Create New Contacts in FluentCRM when a visitor adds a comment in your form. Next, you'll have to set a checkbox label for the comment form. This checkbox lets the user decide whether they want to become a subscriber. In the next two fields, you can assign a list and a tag that will be added to the new contacts. Below this, you can set whether the subscription checkbox is auto-checked for new users and whether to add a new account if the commenting user already exists in the system. Lastly, you can choose whether to send a double opt-in email for confirmation to new subscribers. On our site, we keep these features enabled. You can disable them if you want. The next section is more of a feature than a setting. FluentCRM lets you add custom fields to your contacts view so you can store additional information depending on your needs. This comes in handy if you're using an integration like FluentForms Pro, because FluentForms is capable of pulling many additional pieces of information. Custom fields lets you store this added information in an organized and secure way. For instance, on our system, we wanted to store a contact's conversion URL, date of birth, IP, and username. To do that, we open up the Custom Contacts Field tab and click on Add Field. The Select Field Type dialog box will appear. You can choose from 8 different fields, including single choice, multiple choice, and date. We'll go for single line text. Next, we need to add the label for the custom field. We'll set it to URL. Now, if you go to our contacts and click on a particular contact, and here it is. A new field called URL has been added. Next, we'll look at Smart Links. This feature lets you automatically apply lists and tags to contacts that click on a designated link. To set this up, click on Add New Smart Link, which brings up a setup dialog box. We'll add a title for the link and then paste it in the target link. Next, we'll define the tag that will be added to the contacts. You can assign a list too. This feature comes in handy when you want to add users to a particular list or tag. You can also add a note to these contacts if you want to. And that wraps up the Smart Link settings. This settings option allows you to customize the double opt-in email you have enabled in the email settings. Here you can customize the emails that will be sent. First, we'll fill out the subject line as WPManageNinja, please confirm subscription. The first email contains the confirmation link that prompts the user to confirm their subscription request. The second email contains the confirmation message about their subscription. You can edit those templates as much as you like, even include emojis, smart codes, and many more. To create new emails, just select the text box and type into it. You can use email templates and save them for reuse. Once done editing, simply hit Save Settings and double opt-in email setup is complete. Next, under Global Settings, we have Incoming Webhook Settings. Incoming webhooks let you receive information from third-party applications and plugins and automate workflows in FluentCRM. To create a webhook, click on Create Webhook and a new dialog box opens. In the Name field, we'll add the name of the webhook. We'll name ours FluentForms. In the List field, we need to add the list where the received information will be updated. In this case, we'll set it to New Subscribers. Similarly, we'll set a tag under Tags field. You can set multiple tags and lists, we'll use the potential. Lastly, we'll set the status to subscribed for the contacts that come through this webhook and click Create. FluentCRM will provide a webhook URL which will listen to any incoming request. Along with that, we get some keys that denote specific fields in the contacts view. Paste in the URL and these keys to your third-party application, and the integration will be up and running. With that, our incoming webhook settings is complete. Want to enable people to manage FluentCRM? Here comes CRM Managers. Suppose you want to assign an author to your Compose email templates. To do so, just type in their email address, tick the Email Template Manage checkbox, and click Confirm. Now they can only access the email templates. You can enable or disable such user permissions for every FluentCRM feature, such as CRM dashboard, contacts, emails, forms, automation, and settings accesses. Under Tools, you'll find maintenance features and status reports for your REST APIs. A word of caution, while navigating this section, make sure you know what you're doing. API status denotes if your hosting and email service APIs are working in order. Below API status is cron job status. Under this section, you'll find next runtime for scheduled events in FluentCRM, such as scheduled email sending and scheduled automation tasks. You can choose to run these events manually before the scheduled time with the Run Manually button in the Actions column. In the Danger Zone section, you can reset FluentCRM and clear all stored data. Clicking on Delete and Reset All CRM Data will permanently erase all your FluentCRM data, including contacts, campaigns, settings, and emails. You can also selectively delete data with the Data Cleanup feature. In this case, you have to select the type of log you want to delete. If you want to delete, let's say, email open logs, tick the box and set the filter date in Delete Older Data More Than Filled. We'll set it to 10. This will erase the email open logs that are older than 10 days. Next, we'll go through SMTP email service settings. SMTPs help you route your WordPress emails through third-party email service providers. Here, you can see your verified email IDs that are set up with your email provider. Along with it, you can go to your SMTP plugins directly with Go to SMTP Settings button. The next section is unique for Amazon SES and it deserves its own video, so we'll skip it for now. That's a wrap up for today. Make sure to pause and go back if you had difficulties understanding the video. Get our latest updates on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Stick around to our channel WPManageNinja, hit subscribe and the bell icon for more videos like this.